Welcome to the third phase of the first module, friends. We have already seen how physical data link and network layer works, and we are going to see further understanding of other layers in this particular module. Okay, let us try to see the processing at network layer. When a packet arrives at the network layer, because why we are stressing little more on network layer is because it's very critical component. The receiver's network layer processes data differently than the intermediary routers. Okay, so packet, when the packet arrives at the network layer, something like this, some value. Okay, so from that packet, there is something called destination address. It has to find out where it is to be sent. So that is extracted. Now assume that this is the value. Now what we do is something called lookup. In that lookup process, we look at something called the network layer, look at something called a routing table. Okay, routing table will tell exactly which is the next router to pick up. So once that is done, okay, it picks up this very packet and send it to the data link layer. Okay, sending it out. Okay, so that is what the job of network layer is: pick up a packet, extract destination address, look at the lookup in the routing table and figure out where to send. Simple. Okay, and for that it gives it to data link layer to construct a new frame and send it across. In fact, one of the jobs of network layer is to route that thing between different networks. The networks which it travels across may not be of the same type, but it should always be able to do it. Okay, now let us try to see what the job of transport layer is. Again, through an animation, we have two, one is a sender, the other is a receiver. Both of them, we assume that are TCP. So when the segment is sent, the receiver responds back with something called an ACK or acknowledgement. The data act here is known as a segment. In fact, every layer, the name of data unit is different. At data link layer, it is called frame. At network layer, it is called packet. At transport layer, it is called a segment. So you can see that here the acknowledgement is lost, and because the acknowledgement is lost, there is no reliable communication. But then there is, the sender actually runs something called a timer, which times out if the acknowledgement does not come back in time. So this timeout event actually forces the sender to resend the very segment. So it does, and when it is sent, okay, the acknowledgement comes back and the transmission is done. Now, it is very critical for you to understand this ability of transport layer. TCP does that. For example, whenever you type ls something on telnet or just say type a URL, it is quite possible that your URL before reaching to the website is lost, or your website sends you the page and that page is lost. But TCP manages it. How it is done, you can see that it runs a timer, will find out if there is a timeout and resend that. Okay, the other idea, okay, what if the segment itself is lost? Okay, suppose you type the URL before reaching to the other end, the URL itself is lost. So what TCP will do, again, because it is running a timer, will wait for the acknowledgement. In this case, the receiver has not received this segment, so it is not going to respond back and you are going to timeout. So you know that there is, this thing is not delivered, and then you do it again. So you resend this segment, get the acknowledgement, and so it is delivered. Okay, and this process is known as retransmission. So we can say the transport layer provides reliability by something called retransmission. Okay, now the job of application layer. Application layer actually deals with many applications that user run and provide input with. Okay, user may run an application using a character mode. If you're using old mobile phones, you probably are still using them, or GUI or some other way of doing it. And there are multiple types of applications. So what is the job of application layer? The first job of application layer is to receive commands from various applications. So that's the first job. Once that is done, it generates something called application specific messages. For example, if you type a URL, it will construct something called an HTTP packet. Okay, so HTTP, it contains HTTP header and few other things. Okay, I don't need to describe that thing right now, we'll be learning about them later. So it converts that command into something which the receiving server can understand. Okay, so that's the first job. The next thing, once that is done, that is sent to the receiving transport layer. So, that is the job of the sender's application layer. Receiver's application layer, it receives something which is sent from the sender's transport layer, it is received. Once it is received, it will generate application layer application specific messages, and once application specific messages are received, it will send that thing to specific commands. For example, a URL will be moved to a web server, get something which is moved to a file FTP or a telnet command LS or something is moved to telnet server. So, specific applications will receive those specific commands. Okay. Point is, there is something called application programming interface, which is also possible to have in for example, if you have ever used MAPI in Java or something, you know exactly you can do it. You can call MAPI to send mail from your own program. So, something like that. So, application layer takes that input from and use transport layer to send data across. So, that is the job of the application layer, which is described here. With that note, we conclude the third phase of this particular module number 1. We have overviewed the entire networking system. In fact, we have started with the physical layer and we have seen how application layer works. We have seen physical layer is responsible for sending bits across in form of signals. We have seen that the data link layer adds the header as well as the trailer and construct a frame and send that frame across. Network layer's job is to route the packet through other routers to the receiver. We will decide that, we will work on that, and that is the job of the network layer. We have seen that the transport layer provides reliability to the communication, because network layer in TCP/IP case does not follow reliable model. It's connectionless, just send that data across and forget about everything else. So, transport layer actually expects those packets to get lost. When those packets are lost, we will figure out that they are lost and they will resend those things. So, by doing retransmission, TCP or transport layer will provide reliability to communication. The job of an application layer is to convert, the user will type something and expects a response. So, those things which are typed by user are converted to application specific commands, and those application specific commands are carried across by the transport layer to the other end, and the other end is provided to the server running at the other end. The server responds back, and that response is delivered to the user, and that is the job of the application layer, and all these layers work in sync to solve the networking problem. Okay. So, with that note, we conclude this module. Thank you, friends.